So I'm at Trestle Gallery at Trestle Art Space in Sunset Park at 850 3rd Avenue between 30th and 31st Street.
The current exhibition at Trestle Gallery is Objectify, and it's curated by Daniel Hill and Mary Schirillo. And this is Mary Schirillo's piece in the front entrance here. And this is a Mylar work with paint on it. The piece is called Skinny Dip 2.
Just sort of see, based on my scale, that the size of this beautiful wall hanging.
These are the other artists in the show, and let's go look at their work. So this is Dan Hill's work, and he's interested in the sort of minimal abstraction and process, building up the surfaces. These are really fantastic works to see in person, and also as the quality of the light changes throughout the day. The curators put together a catalog for the exhibition, and it's available to purchase on the website. Has a statement by the curators, and then also fantastic photos of all the pieces in the show. Here is Jim Osmond's work. This piece is called Picnic, and it's wood and paint. And Jim does really interesting stuff with the plane shifts of these objects, kind of letting the paint stop and start as the plane shifts. This work is by Richard van der A, and he gets these fantastic surfaces. This is enamel on aluminum, and it's called Flat Formalities Number 1. This work here is Guido Winkler, and a longer title, One of the Endless Possibilities of Seeing a Particular Rectangle a Little Differently. And this is acrylic on wood. It's a really nice hard-edged abstraction, symmetry, and then there's that kink in the wood that adds to value shift with how the light hits.
Here we are in the main space of the gallery, and you can see that the works in the show, they all straddle the space or the line between sculpture and painting. And Dan and Mary, the guest curators, really explored all kinds of sort of viewing relationships to the body. Patricia Zarate's piece on slender stems, and she has a whole series of these works.
Patricia Zarate's work, and what's interesting, she was part of the panel discussion at the gallery. But what's interesting about these works is that they're floating off the wall a little bit to create an additional color in the negative space between the two pieces of painted wood, kind of create another third optical color. These works are by Emma Langridge and called Medium Cubes, and it's enamel and acrylic on wood. And you can see how the artist has kind of made sort of striped composition that sometimes aligns with the edge of the plane, and then sometimes it kind of is that it comes in at an angle. But it's almost as if the paint is kind of wrapping the forms, and you get this play between the cast shadows and the sort of blacks kind of interlacing, and a continuity from one cube to the next, even though they're separate objects. Bogomila Strojna, and it's an interesting use of kind of industrial materials. So we have plexiglass and tracing paper, and the title has a whimsical title, Space Generator. And so you get this optical illusion of a sort of drawn rectangle, but it's really like the negative space that's taken up by the plexiglass. This work is also by Bogumila Strojna. This piece is called Space Generator. Just like the other piece, there's a kind of industrial texture quality, but shown in this context, like the material recontextualized in a gallery space and transforms or transcends its original purpose. So I have no idea what this material was for originally, but it becomes this kind of engaging textured surface. And it's interesting how the artist is able to the same kind of play with negative space in both a small piece and large piece. Okay, this work is also by Richard van der Aa, Platformalities number 23. And again, enamel, in this case on Dibon. This work is by Imke van Dijk, and it's untitled. It's porcelain discs that are laid out on the floor. I saw the artist when she was installing. She was using a template. That's where you get this sort of really systematic placement of all the forms. And this is done with porcelain. These are little porcelain discs. Initially, this piece was going to be sort of in the center of the gallery.
But what they decided to do out of security for the artwork is to have it coming out of the corner so that the piece looks like it's emerging, like there's this implied continuation.
This work is by Robert Berenguer, and it's called Leonigas or Glove. And it looks like a casually folded piece of paper, but it's actually really intentionally folded aluminum with a matte acrylic finish. This is Laura Nilny, and they're called the Dance of the Chameleon. And what's interesting is that they're made with these little topped structures that imply a movement or change. Like if you were to spin them, you get a different composition. And even the placement on the floor implies kind of a playful game. Here's another piece by Patricia called On Slender Stems Pink. And this work, Guido Winkler, called One Possibilities of Seeing a Particular Rectangle a Little Differently. You can see how this panel is also folded to create a play on optical visual illusion of space and form. There's another piece by Robert Bernier. This piece is called Songo Pavimo di Giovanni Lorenzetti. A very epic sounding title. Yeah. This is another cube by Emma. This is the extra large or XL cubed one. Very nice. And this work called Tête, Jim Osman. And Tête is French for head. So you can read a little bit of a profile in there as well. And there's always a sort of playful assemblage, sort of collaging of various surfaces and materials.
Objectify is open Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturdays from 1:30 to 6:30, and will be on view until November 4th. Hope to see you here. Bye.